Hello, I'm Mr. Arnicher, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I'm doing John 13, verse 1 to 15. Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own friends, laboring brethren in the world, and he loved them in the end and to the very core of his heart, as expected of a good shepherd and the bridegroom. Remember Jesus, you know, when he was eating at the place of Matthew, some Pharisees who came, "Hey, your disciples do not wash their hand or pray and fast as the disciple of John the Baptist, Pharisee and Sadducean laborers and rabbis do." Now the root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline natural men. So their intake was natural and they were told to pray and fast to imaginary demiurge God called Yahweh, who is not real. So the laborers of Jesus, they were twice born. They're not once born, natural men. They were spiritual. So they could understand spiritual language only if they were spiritual or had the Holy Spirit. So then the Jesus told these Pharisees to see who were asking his laboring brethren that the bridegroom, Christ Jesus, is in their heart, they don't need to pray and fast. So the Christ in us, when we preach gospel in honor of Jesus, as you know, when you are married to a woman, and woman when she speaks on behalf of the husband, Mrs. So-and-so, not as Miss anymore. So when we are married to Jesus, then we become his virgin brides. Spiritual marriages, in that one you remain solitary. In the secular one, fleshly one, you are no more solitary, but you become Mrs. and you have a master. So Jesus told them that so far the bridegroom is in their heart. They don't need to fast or they don't need to worry about anything, cry or anything. So, but when he is gone, as it is today, there is no Christ in their hearts. They just vomit out what is written, scripture. The Christ doesn't need scripture because Christ is his word himself. So that's why Jesus said, if you go on a preaching gospel, don't take any money, no two shoe, no two shurik, and no script. Script means scripture, this Bible. You don't take it with you. Otherwise you will just vomit out the what is written without understanding, because gospel rests in your heart. And gospel is called logo. Logo, you only get it when you are capable of logical reasoning yourself. Nobody can do logical reasoning for you. So if you want gospel, you have to think logically. When you think logically, then Christ is in your heart. So when Christ is in your heart, then you don't pray and fast, because that pray and fast language is of Yahweh, demiurge, alienated, God. This is the temple of God. God is inside me. Me and my Father are one. That's why Jesus came to make us the sons of the Most High, as He Himself was. So with this introduction, now you will understand why Jesus washed the feet and other things. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power and that he had come from God and was returning to God, our Father, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments of this world. This is the outer garment, this physical body. And my heart is the inner garment. So Jesus took out this outer garment, that he is no more and is superior to the other one. Then he opened his heart to welcome them into the royal kingdom of God. Royal kingdom of God is inside here. Kingdom of heaven is law and order, is of rabbis. That kingdom of heaven related to this one, flesh. Ask Syrian people, where is hell and heaven? They will tell you. Royal kingdom of God, just the opposite. Inside, not outside. So he took the outer garment away. He opened his heart to welcome them into the royal kingdom of God. And assume the inner garments, the core of his heart, to in honor of our Father. So in honor of our Father, to glorify Him, you know. So He bring in the laborers to the presence of our Father in His heart. He took a towel and tied it around His waist. Then He poured water into a basin and began to wash the feet of His friends and dry them with towel around His waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Peter was once born, and he was of natural man, but honest like a little child. And he loved his teacher as expected of the disciples of the rabbis. They did what their disciples, their rabbis told them to do. But Jesus was solitary. He made other people solitary. Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing, you do not understand." Because you do not understand now, because he was once born. He could not understand gospel or anything what Jesus was doing. But you will understand later when you get at Pentecost the very Spirit of God. That's why Peter, when he died, he told his executor to hang him upside down, because he was once born. What once born people do of flesh, the opposite apply to spirit. So Paul was spiritual. He had the key to the kingdom of heaven, heaven, law and order. That is why he killed two liars, Ananias and Sapphira, whereas none of the other apostles hate or killed anyone. So being of flesh, given the kingdom of heaven, so he said, "Hang me upside down, crucify me upside down." That's why his cross is upside down, Peter's. Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Peter was once born and he loved his teacher as expected of the disciples of the rabbis. Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing, you do not understand now, and you will understand later. Peter said to him, you will never wash my feet. Jesus answered him, unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me. Inheritance me, you can't enter my heart. Royal kingdom of God. Then we are together, you know, in the royal kingdom of God. Simon Peter said to him, Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well. Jesus said to him, whoever has bathed or been baptized by John the Baptist in the name of Abraham, those who became the salt of Abraham, they were clean. They won't do anything wrong. They were righteous people. So their hand will do only right thing, not wrong thing. Has no need except to have his feet washed. Which the arrogant Pharisees, Simon, did not to honor Jesus. Remember, he went to the house of the Pharisee, Simon. And he was arrogant, you know. He just wanted to test Jesus. What type of knowledge he has. He was very arrogant. So he did not wash his feet. Mary Magdalene came. She washed his feet with the tears of love, extreme love. You know, when you are in extreme love with somebody, then you cry also. So she washed the feet and dried them up with her head hair, which is her honor. With her honor, she dried it. She honored Jesus very, very great. So, which the arrogant Pharisee Simon did not to honor Jesus into his house, but to test him, had done. So he did not do, he did not honor Jesus, you know, but Jesus honored the laborers into the house of our Father by washing their feet, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all. Not all mean there's a Judas Iscariot maybe he's talking about, for he knew who would betray him. For this reason he said, not all of you are clean. I understand, you know, that Jesus, when he was eating the supper, then he told the Judas Iscariot to go out and do his job. So when he was started washing the feet, there were not 12 but 11 of them. So this to be noted, you know, because into the royal kingdom of God, into the royal kingdom of God, those who worship Mammon, they can't enter. Because this temple of God, if you worship Mammon, then Mammon is inside and God is out. But if you are not worshipping Mammon, you are righteous person, honest, you know, your temple is clean like little child. No hypocrisy, nothing, no love for Mammon. Then God is inside and Mammon is out. But in Judas Iscariot, Mammon was in and God was out. So he was not present at the washing ceremony. He was out of them. He was the Jesus washed only 11 of them, their feet. So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. This is a corruption, you know, where Messianic Jews, they have corrupted the Old and the New Testament. So when he took the, remember the parable of the marriage of the son, when everybody was eating and drinking, and then the father comes himself. Then he found one man not properly dressed. And that, the name of that man who was not properly dressed was Judas Iscariot. So he was thrown out as Jesus did when he was eating the Last Supper. By Last Supper, everybody knew that he's a thief. He steals money from the bus, except Peter. So that's why Peter was nudging, you know, to tell who is going to betray you. So the other people knew who he is. So this is a corruption by the Messianic Jews. As Jesus washed their feet to welcome them into the house of our Father within our own heart, within his own heart. So he was one with us. So he loved us to us, but to the end of his time. So where the marriage of the Son, Christ Jesus, was celebrated through Eucharist, or entering into the bridal chamber. So then afterward, washing their feet, then he broke the bread and drank the wine. Breaking the bread was, this is my flesh. Remember when Jesus feed the 5,000 people? Then he opened his mouth. You can't preach gospel to hungry people. You need to first satisfy their food hunger or Yahweh's hunger. So after feeding them with food, nice bread meal, then he opened his mouth and says, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me. So after this washing of the feet, and when he had entertained them, when he brought them into the house of our Father, or into his own heart, then he celebrated the Eucharist, which is entering into the bridal chamber. He broke the bread, unleavened bread, that this is my body of Jesus. Take it. This is the covenant. And that means what came out of the mouth of Jesus. Hear it with this one, in which they have heard. And at that time, when 5,000 was fed, and Jesus started his ministry with these words, his laborers could not understand him. They also thought, literal sense, that cut me into pieces and eat it. The other 5,000 literal people, they run away, people of the book. So then Jesus came to his laborer, do you want to go also? They said, no, we want to stay. But that time they also were in a puzzle, you know, what he meant by this one, eating the flesh and drinking the blood. Drinking the blood means after you have listened to Jesus, daily bread, our living bread, take it to your heart, chew it with the teeth of logical reasoning to brew logo. And when you have brewed the logo, which is his word, then you preach it from your own gospel, from your own heart, the gospel of our Father. Then you can explain to everyone, how did you get it? Because you have thought logically. That's why 10 virgins, 5 were sealed to serve God, 5 were clever. They thought, hey, we can just knock and go. So those who were sealed to serve God, they knocked at the door called Abba, Abba, Father, Father. And he opened the door, sons, come in. The other 5 virgins went there, psychic. They wanted to praise him, you know. They knock the door, Lord, Lord, Lord. Now lords have slaves. Yahweh is the Lord. Lord, Yahweh had the slaves. Our Father, His Spirit, He set you free. He doesn't enslave people. And slaves cannot enter into the house or occupy the property of the Father. So when they knocked at the door, said, Lord, 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 He said, there's no Lord in here. I don't enslave people. I set them free. Go and get lost. And their oil was less. Go and get your oil first. Learn something about gospel. Then come to me and recognize me as your Father. Then I will open the door for you. So the psychic are clever, you know. They always try to boost the ego of the people. So sometimes I tell these church people, you know, that God is our Father, not Lord. No, no, we will call Him Lord. And Jesus also, they will call Him Lord. Jesus clearly said that no, don't call anybody Father. We have one Father God, and we are brethren. And how they make Him Lord and everything, pump Him up, He doesn't like that. So Christ Jesus was celebrated through Eucharist, or entering into the bridal chamber. If I, therefore, the Master and Teacher, have washed your feet, you are to wash one another's feet, which is absolute nonsense. So these people, you know, with the dog collars, with the robes, they are the Messianic Jews who occupied the Church of God. In the first century they occupied it. And they bring in Torah, the Jewish leaven, which is forbidden, into the church. And they made people to read that Old Testament, and they occupied the church. And when the apostles used to come and they saw what the hell they are doing, they are making them drunk with the old wine of the letters, desiring not the new. As in Jerusalem, they did not like Jesus. Samaritan village people, Gentile, they loved Jesus. So they rebuked the bishop. Bishop told them, do what I tell you to do, otherwise don't come to my church. So he threw them out. Light came among his own, and his own loved darkness. So then they start killing these apostles, and all that, the atrocities they did. So this, when they got this robed one, you know, dog-collared priest and other thing, because royal priests don't need any uniform, any clothing, because this is the temple of God. So they are sitting in the heart and not on the chair. So when they occupied this Church of God and they put on their dog collars, and also they established the same system as in the temple it was, they had a bishop who became the temple high priest. And then they start killing people, filling Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, the arid spirit, temple, the priest, or the husbandmen who were sacked from the wine press, which was the temple, producing moral laws. They could not find any good job, so they entered the Church of God and occupied it, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. So they start killing people and other things. So they also then used to have people to wash their feet, you know, every day, and get, you know, very comfortable. They were like lavish living, as you see today, these people, pastor, you know, driving cars and other, living in a house supplied by the congregation, which is turning bread, stones into bread. Stone means thick-headed people, simpletons, simple-minded people. They give donations and they live on those donations, which is stealing money from the church purse. They are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. So that's what it is, you know, wrong. You know, I have given you a model to follow so that I have done for you, you should also do. This is a corruption again, as I told you. These bishops must have been getting their feet washed by their stooges every day. So there you are. So this the outer and inner. This is the outer garment, which Jesus took it out, and then he opened his heart to welcome the his brethren or his friends, virgin friends, virgin brides, and he performed the marriage ceremony through Eucharist. That's what John the Baptist said, I'm baptizing in water, one coming after me will baptize you in Holy Spirit. That is the Holy Spirit baptism, Eucharist. But these days, every day, you know, people drink Eucharist, Eucharist, they call it as remembrance and this and that. This is all nonsense. You need to be royal priest. If you want to be royal priest, you need to be solitary, capable of seeking the narrow gate that leads to the royal kingdom of God, where the true wine, Christ Jesus, has been planted by our Father. You have to graft yourself to that true wine. That means you have to eat the flesh of Jesus, and then you will be able to preach the gospel. Eat the flesh of Jesus with this ear, not this ear. This year. So then you can preach the gospel. That is, then you are part and parcel of Christ Jesus. So our Father God bless you, and happy Easter, and hope we will make progress. If you like my videos, pass it on to other people, so that in Jesus we don't make following. If you follow somebody, then you are a blind person. We ourselves walk in daylight. So far you are walking in daylight, you can't go wrong. So far you can think logically yourself, you can't go wrong. But if you start follow somebody, then you are walking in the darkness, night, that the rabbis had created. Like rabbis, you have become his disciple. As Saul was the disciple of Gamaliel, but his conscience wasn't happy to persecute the laborers of Jesus. But he was doing it because Gamaliel has instructed him to do. I have given much detail of this one. Our Father God bless you.